All right, taking a look. 30-second clock is up, and here we see Johan Kristoffersson, who Travis wanted to get a shot at, but that's not going to happen. And we got Oliver Eriksson. All right, Johan Kristoffersson, Ollie Eriksson. You can see the stats there. Four-time. We saw the stars on the belt. And for his debut, he had a great run there when we saw the seeding heats earlier. And for his maiden voyage, that was a great run. Coley, go ahead, bud. Wrap out. Get him pumped.
Kristoffersson looks down to the dash, so experienced. Four times a champion, but Eriksson, from the family that built these cars, gets a better start on the run to the first corner. Kristoffersson gets in his door. Eriksson goes sideways. Johan will be patient on the inside line, going to try and get a big jump, stay alongside him on the run to turn two. Sideways for Kristoffersson, almost collects Eriksson. Eriksson mines the poles on the inside of turn two. Sideways, it couldn't have been closer. Four-time world champion up behind him. This one's going to be interesting.
That was some great, what do you mean, going to be? It is.
Yeah.
Absolutely right out of the gate. And like you said, the family that built to the Oldsburgs, right there on the side, but Johan Kristoffersson getting into it. You can see a little battered and bruised, but no big deal. Johan really airing it out. Really well done there. Let's even get him on the gap. Look at Johan. I mean, flirting with it over the gap. Relax. Zero chill.
Mate, that's parking distance over the gap jump behind Eriksson. Now on the handbrake inside. I expect him to go Joker immediately, and he does. So that's to try and give himself. He would love two laps. He'd like Eriksson to stay out, but I tell you what, he's done it 100 times in one lap. So Eriksson will know, and I am absolutely certain he'll respond on the next lap.
Yep, so here we go. You can see the gap there, 3.4 seconds. We saw it needs to be sub three to even have a shot at regaining that lead or getting that lead from Ollie for Johan Kristoffersson.
Over the curb on the inside line, right the way over, and then to the left. These cars have got such good travel that they're capable of doing that, and the gaps come down. 3.1, so he takes a couple of tenths off him. Kristoffersson goes purple in sector number one. This is his specialty, Jared, nailing a lap when he absolutely has to. He goes purple in sector two, it's 2.9.
Man. And look at that, we're talking about Ollie Eriksson, he's yellow. So that shows you he's slowing down. He knows who's in his rearview mirror. Look at that, airing it out. So you see right on the middle, doesn't use all the cushion. Big angle there.
Eriksson, he stayed out, Jared. He stayed out. I think that's a big mistake. He's already purple. On the other hand, he kind of doesn't have any choice because Kristoffersson's gone purple sector. Eriksson responds on the third sector of that lap, but at 2.9, he's too close. I guess maybe the spotter's gone, mate, you don't have enough. You need a good third lap.
Absolutely, yeah. So the spotter, I mean, they're seeing the results. They're seeing the time slips. You know, we have, obviously, all the data. So he's in his ear. So 3.04 seconds. I mean, that's flirting with it. So his spotter's saying, Ollie, stay tidy. Don't mess up. Continue on that line.
Over the big jump goes Eriksson in the background. There is Kristoffersson.
Wow.
It's a huge air from Kristoffersson. Yeah, front of the car with the hood up again. 3.1. So Eriksson has responded. Two green personal best. Not going as quickly as Kristoffersson did on the previous lap, but he has managed to edge it out. He goes into the Joker lap now. Going to be close as they come through the left-hander.
And here we go. Johan Kristoffersson. He is trying to go for it. Is it going to be enough? Oliver Eriksson comes out swinging and literally crosses across the finish line first. So well done by Ollie Eriksson. Holding off that four-time champ. Great, I mean, you know what? Great debut for Johan, but at the end of the day, Ollie Eriksson took the win.
I was certain he'd respond on lap two, Jared. I was wrong, but did he not respond because he never wanted to, or did they look at the splits and go, mate, you go now and you're gone?